Hey guys, so this is one of my PJ broadcasts. So normally I talk about pretty much most of the stuff that's gone on in the gaming world kind of thing in the last week, but to be honest, personally for me, nothing much has really gone on in the last week. So the one thing that I am going to talk about today is Nintendo Labo. So obviously a lot of people have their opinions about this and whether they think it's good, whether they think it's bad. I'm going to go pretty much at this with its pros and its cons and try and explain pretty much what you're getting. So first thing to know is that Nintendo Labo comes in three different kind of packages that you can buy it in. So first of all, you get the first pack, which is $59.99, and this is like a multi-pack. a multi-pack, and it has a few different ones. So it has the piano, it has the house in it, it has the fishing rod in it, and it also has, I believe, one bug, and I'm calling it a bug. It reminds me of Bamzuki when they used to like go across the table. But yeah, so it's got one bug in it, and it's also got, it kind of reminds me of a drum kit, but it's to do with, it's a pedal for a car or a motorbike, and you've got the top to do the motorbike with. So that is pack one. Pack two is $69.99, it's £10 more, and that is your robot pack. So that is the one you see the young boy, and he has like a visor on, he's got the foot at the back, he's got the bits attached to his feet, etc. And then the third pack that a lot of people aren't really talking about is you can buy the bugs separately, and the bugs separately are $8.99. So, all in all, no, I'm fine, thanks. But all in all, Nintendo Labo, in my eyes, is quite a good idea. I do appreciate the idea and I'm interested in it. I have personally put in to see if I can test it. You can actually still apply to see if you can test it. And this is in London, so it is the UK based, but I'll leave a link down below. It's on the Nintendo website if you want to give a go. Like, if you get to test it, that's awesome. I'll also put the trailer, or the, yeah, it's like a trailer, I guess, down below for Nintendo Labo as well. If you just wanna, if you haven't really heard a lot about it and you wanna check it out, that'll be down below too. So for me, there are many pros, but there are many cons in regards to this. So first of all, what you need to know is that Nintendo Labo is completely made out of cardboard. I can't see this being poor quality cardboard from Nintendo, but nevertheless, cardboard is cardboard. So this is a good idea by Nintendo, and while on the advert, if you do watch the advert or the trailer, you will see them go quite hard with the props. Eventually cardboard bends, cardboard breaks and stuff like that. So that is definitely a con. Obviously it's not a con, the whole thing's not a con, but it's definitely a bad side of it. I am really looking forward to it. I think it's a very niche concept. It is a very good idea. The fact that they are saying that you can obviously, they're aiming this towards children. So they're saying if your kid likes red and blue, they can paint it, they can colour it in, they can use patterned tape if they want to, and basically put it in. The second downside I can see of this is it is very, very, best way to say it is, I look at some of those, I have got a degree in art and design, and I've done graphics, I have done many things like that, and I can fully see me having a few issues with a few of the more complicated builds. So for instance, the piano, and perhaps even like the piano, or when it comes to the robot or stuff like that. So yeah, it kind of, you can really, I can see the issues. As a parent, if you haven't got any creative skills, some people haven't, some people are more mathematical minded, which is fine, you're gonna have issues with it. Unfortunately, obviously they do all come on a pre-cut cardboard sheet, which is serrated, and all you do is pop them out. Also on the advert, as you can clearly see, they have created a video for this. So what you can do is just follow the video along 100%. It will say like, fold this, do this. So it should be easy. But also the other thing that I can think of, which is definitely a downside to this, is in regards to children. Children get bored. They want to play with things. They don't want to play with things. You put things up, put things down. And in regards to this, I can only see it going up and down a couple of times before one parent gets annoyed with it and kind of go, that's enough, and it stays up. Or two, as a kid, be honest, you all left your toys on the floor, you all tripped over them, your parents tripped over them, the dog ran over them, the cat laid on them. So yeah, I can see that being an issue. And also, just they're aiming it towards children. Children have sticky fingers, they spill drinks. I remember personally when I was a child getting overexcited because Simpsons was on BBC Two, and that's the original, showing how old I am now, but that's the original channel it used to be on, and walking, running into the front room with my dinner, which was shepherd's pie, and just tripping or stumbling and just going on the carpet in front of me. So easily done. So I can see many issues with in regards to this. All in all, the good sides, I like the fact that your kid likes mermaids, then you let them paint the house like a mermaid's tail. Do you know what I mean? It's customable, and you're not paying for that customization like you normally do. So in, for instance, the Nintendo Switch, you're not paying additional for additional pro controllers or Joy-Cons that are neon yellow or the Splatoon green and pink. You are already having a customization because it's completely plain and you can do what you want to it. I really like that, and I think that's a very new way of looking at it. I like the way that obviously Nintendo's gone about this. So in regards to the price, obviously people are moaning about the price. So first thing to remember is, I said the first multi-pack, which had loads in, is $59.99, and the second is $69.99. So first thing to remember is that includes the gameware, and it is hard copy as far as I'm aware. So you're actually getting a box, obviously the box with the gameware in it and all the packs to do it with and all the instructions. So if you look at most of the Nintendo Switch software at the moment, that ranges from about £50 to £60. So that's each title, and that also includes some of their downloaded content as well. So if you are looking at it like you are paying £50 for the software, you're technically paying £5 for the cardboard. I'm sure eventually Nintendo will bring out the cardboard on its own, so perhaps if you break it, almost like they've done with the bug, they've brought out the bug separately for $8.99, so you can perhaps have four or five bugs if you want to. Obviously you've got to have the Joy-Cons to actually plug into it, but still, then it's not going to be so bad anyway, because you're going to be able to replace those for a cheaper price. Unfortunately, you are looking at it like, once you've made these, you have to be able to use the Nintendo Switch with them. So one of the downsides that I can see is in regards to the more expensive pack, which is the robot pack. One, that looks really, really complicated. Like, she opens the box in the advert and it's got like moving bits and loads of elastic bands and stuff, and it just looks really complicated. But the other thing is, the kid has a visor that goes over his head, and genuinely that looks to me like it's the actual screen for the Nintendo Switch, because obviously this is compatible with the Switch, which is great, but how long can you actually sit there and look at that screen before it is actually really bad for you? General concern, but I'm sure they have tested it. obviously, but then they didn't test their 3D on young children, and that's why they had to make the 2DSs. So it does raise some concerns in regards to, obviously, the compatibility with the Nintendo Switch. Most of them either use both Joy-Cons and the screen, or they will use the screen and the right Joy-Con. So the reason they use the right Joy-Con is because it has that little screen on the bottom, which I'll link pictures up below as well. But because it has that little screen, that's obviously your sensor, and it basically works with most of the sensors. That's how the piano works. So you make the piano, you put the right Joy-Con in, which on the neon ones is the red one, like ready orange one, and then obviously it senses just pretty much basic. It's more basic than the Wii remote and the sensor bar. It just senses what ones you're pressing from like pre-recorded information put into it. So there's that. So it is a good concept, and I said I am quite looking forward to it. I think it'll be quite interesting. I have no idea where I'm going to store it. As most of you know, I have twins on the way, and finding somewhere where I can place that, where it's not going to get broken, touched, thrown up on, pooed on, all that kind of stuff, is going to be ridiculous. Plus, when it comes to moving, and I do move, then it's going to be incredibly difficult on how does it unfold, and if so, can it be unfolded and not broken? The other thing I was personally thinking was, I love the tape concept. So if you go to your local Hobbycraft or just craft store, you can get funky coloured tapes, and they are great to cover anything. So if your kids have got like school books, you can let them cover their school books so they know which one's theirs, which is great. But you're already taping the product. So you have to, if you're letting your children do that, you're already kind of saying this is going to be built and stay up. And I said finding a place to store these kind of items, because they don't look like small items. So I would say the piano looks about that big to me. So that's quite big, because you've got to be able to put the screen on top of it, and it's bigger than the screen width wise and then obviously length wise it looks about. And there's one 10 inches, so it's still reasonably big. And then, okay, the stuff like the bug don't necessarily hold up that much space, but as one of my friends who I asked today at work literally pointed out, all it takes is, with the bugs personally, you to bend one of those little legs, and then you're already trying to like tape it so it moves along, because otherwise it's not going to move along flat, unfortunately. I can see so many pros and so many cons towards this. As I've said, I am looking forward to this. I have pre-ordered the full set, which was about £130, because I couldn't decide on what ones to get, so it was cheaper in the long run to get all of them. That was off of Game in the UK, because you can't actually pre-order on the Nintendo store at the moment. So it does make me wonder, because this is coming out on the 4th month, so that April, and we're already through January, and apparently you can't pre-order it yet, which is only technically about 3 months away, maybe just over. So it does make me wonder if this is going to get put back and delayed a little bit. We will see. This is either going to be something from Nintendo that everybody is going to absolutely adore, or kind of another one of those niche things that Nintendo does that everybody kind of goes, why? Almost like the Nintendo Game Boy Advance e-reader. I have one of those under my bed, but it's pretty pointless. The Nintendo, oh, let me try and think of some more. You have obviously games on the DS, which are quite obscure. So you have a glucose reader for people or children with diabetes, and that is genuinely an actual thing. You have the Wii Fit bike, which is quite difficult to find, which is an actual exercise bike that works with the Wii and has a disc and everything to go with the Wii. But again, storage is an issue, and originally the price on release was an issue. because you were buying an exercise bike. You have the original DS games that were like Guitar Hero, Band Hero, and even like the Walker Meter ones that just didn't really hit off. So I said, I am looking forward to this and I would really like to see how this goes. I want to see how easy it is to make, and I want to see, like, almost I want to know what spares it comes with as well, in regards to if you buy Lego Dimensions, you get a few spare bricks just in case you lose one, you drop one, you anything like that. I am personally thinking, how many spare elastic bands do you get? Because you can see elastic bands within regards to the movement, helping them go back. Also, the other thing that I thought of, in the robot one, you'll see in the advert, the child has obviously the bit on his back, the bit on his head. He has one bit attached to either foot, so when he moves, you can tell. And attaching the foot to the box on his back was string. So in regards to that, in my mind, the first thing that came to my mind was, this is subject and obviously aimed towards children. I'm an adult and I'm 5'7". So is the string going to reach? If you've got a considerably tall child, and this is technically still going for a child's present, but they're quite tall, is it going to reach? Are you going to get enough string to be able to change the lengths, or is it a preset? And then obviously then you're already going out and buying more expense, because you're going to go out and buy more string so you can make it fit. So those are my concerns and my thoughts. As I said, I have pre-ordered it. I'll leave a link down below if you're in the UK and you want to pre-order everything to the game website. So I'll leave that link down there too. It's your choice. Let me know in the comments what you think. Do you think it's a good idea? I've obviously given my thoughts on good and bad, just because I can see both. But obviously a lot of people are kind of like, what the fuck? Because it is weird from Nintendo, but personally Nintendo is a weird company. They do lots and lots of weird things. In the long run, everything, most of the time, they're weird pays off, and then maybe 5 to 10% of the time their weird doesn't pay off. So hopefully this is a payoff for them. They've done so well on the Switch anyway, so hopefully this adds to the success. But yeah, let me know what you think in the comments down below. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe for more videos like this one, and obviously just leave me any comments down below. I reply to all my comments, and I will see you guys next time. So